Hello. I'm going to present our work using the cysteine X RNA analysis for the gut microbiota in a brain injury in Alzheimer's disease animal model. So the brain-gut microbiome axis relates to the interactions between the brain and the gastrointestinal tract, in which the alterations of these systems can change the other and vice versa. So the established communication pathways are the immune-endocrine signaling pathway through the cytokines and hormone release into circulation, the neural pathway through the vagus nerve, and the microbial pathway that consists of the release of the microbial compounds into the blood circulation, and that also can interact with the brain. So the gut microbiota are essential neuromodulators of the brain-gut signaling, and we know that the intestinal bacteria helps the digestive process and other physiological functions. However, when we have an alteration on the brain-gut axis, this microbiota can release compounds that interact with the intestinal epithelium, and also can activate the immune cells that produce gut peptides, which serve as compounds that communicate with the brain. The enteric neurons also that are activated and produce neurochemical signals that can travel through the vagus nerve and communicate with the brain. So in general, the inflammation that is induced in the gut by the gut microbiota can regulate the central nervous system immunity, function, behavior, and response to neurodegenerative disease and other pathologies. So from the juvenile stage to the adult and elderly stage, the brain-gut communication undergoes different changes. So the blood-brain barrier, permeability, the production of the cytokines, and are reduced in the adult stage of the brain. As well, the gut can produce several compounds, as the GABA and another neuropeptides that can communicate with the brain. But the most important is the microbiota diversity in the adults that are increased, and that this diversity is decreased in the older adults. As well, in the older adults, we found that there are more inflammation and more toxic compounds released by the gut, and that all that can have a repercussion into the brain and also in the brain function. So we know that the brain damage and the inflammatory cascade that occurs are associated with the risk of developing neurodegenerative disease as Alzheimer's disease, right? So the compounds like the amyloid beta metabolism or the inflammatory cascade that they are produced after TBI have a detrimental effect on the neurodegeneration in Alzheimer's disease. So also we know that the gut microbiota has been involved in the production and accumulation of the amyloid plaques in Alzheimer's disease. So we think that the gut microbiota composition in Alzheimer is detrimental to the recovery of brain damage. So we have, to prove this hypothesis, we have two aims. The first one, we want to identify the change in the gut from the young, aged, and Alzheimer's disease mice. And also we want to analyze the effect of the fecal microbiota transplants from young in Alzheimer's disease mice on the outcome of the post-traumatic brain injury. So we designed the following experiment in young, aged, and Alzheimer's disease mice. We extracted the bacterial DNA from the stool samples or the feces. We did the cysteine X amplicons and the barcoded, and we pulled it into libraries using the Nanopore kit, followed by sequencing or a minium platform. So we performed the bioinformatic analysis. And the traditional, as you know, the traditional cysteine X analysis only looks at the subset of the variability regions, but the Oxford Nanopore enables full length of the cysteine X RNA analysis and allows to look at the entire gene, so including all the variability regions. So definitely, we have developing a new pipeline, more useful and to analyze the full length of the cysteine X RNA data that is called nano-cysteine X. So the reads are corrected then and are classified via cracking and minimap too. And then we use the Pavian to visualize the classification. And we then also calculate the relative abundance of each organism in the sample. So all results you can see here in this. And this is a Pavian visualization that the Lactobacillus family, in specific the Lactobacillus johnsonii, is the most dominant bacteria in the young animals in the gut microbiome. Around the 38% of the bacteria that are johnsonii, Lactobacillus johnsonii. And the Lactobacillus is still most abundant genus in the aged mouse, but however, if we compare to the young animals, the abundance of the Lactobacillus species drop from 50% to 30% in the animals. In Alzheimer animals, a decrease is observed in the Lactobacillus species, notably the Lactobacillus johnsonii compared to young and similar to aged. So overall, we can see that the aged is more similar to the Alzheimer mice, and both differ considerably compared to the young animals. When we see these three graphs here together with the comparison of the three groups, we can overall say that Alzheimer animals have more similar than the aged animals, but the Lactobacillus reuteri definitely is the bacteria that differs stronger in Alzheimer. So we performed different experiments, and we want to carry out the following experiment that consists in the induced traumatic brain injury into the cortex of these animals. So we were inducing inflammation on these animals. And then we did the treatment with the fecal microbiota transplants and from the control young healthy mice and then from the animals with Alzheimer's disease. And we administered that by oral lavage to the animal they suffer injury. And we analyzed different pathologies and neuroinflammation and lesion volume into the brain. And also we performed some behavior and motor testing. As well, we did the nanopore sequencing in the animals they were transplanted with the fecal matter transplants. So we know that the microbiome that we saw on the animals they were transplanted, they differ from the one the others, but they were very similar with the recipient. So we can it's a indication that we got a successful colonization. So as you know, that the pathology of the brain of the Alzheimer brain is different than the young animals, and we have a massive accumulation, the amyloid beta accumulation and plaques. You can see here in red, and as well we have more inflammation than the control animals that you can see here in green. So we want to see that the fecal matter transplants can revert this pathology. We found that the fecal matter transplants from the animals that were transplants with Alzheimer feces, so they have more lesion, standard lesion in the brain, and also the recovery was worse. So definitely the fecal matter transplant from Alzheimer was detrimental for the brain recovery. As well, we saw that on the inflammation. We saw more microglia, macrophages, and more astrogliosis in the animals that they got the fecal matter transplant from Alzheimer. We compared it with the animals they got the fecal matter transplants from the young in healthy controls. So nevertheless, we didn't see any difference, for example, in all the markers as the neutrophil infiltration. So definitely the change they were in neuroinflammation and in the central inflammation. So as conclusions, we can say that the full length of the 16X and RNA sequencing allows to refine a look into the genus and species level of the analysis. Also, we can see that the inflammation after brain injury was exacerbated, and then the motor ability as well was worse in the animals that received the fecal matter transplant from the Alzheimer microbiota. And definitely the Lactobacillus species, specifically the Lactobacillus reuteri and johnsonii, can be a good target for probiotic treatment for Alzheimer disease. In summary, the microbiota from aged animals and has a detrimental effect on the pathology and the recovery of the brain injury. And just to finish, I want to thank to my lab and the Houston Metropolitan Institute, also the people in the Trenges lab at Rice University for all the analysis presented in this project. And of course, thanks to the Rishan Institute and Methodist Hospital, and then the NIH for the funding. Thank you so much.